Happy Monday to the people of God. Me and my son stayed up so late watching other ministries online, shouting and praising and crying and worshiping and decreeing and declaring. It was beautiful. We bonded beautifully over the things of the Lord, the promises of the Lord. And I looked over and Jared was like out. We literally were like, hallelujah. And after I looked over, I was like, Jared, I should have took a picture or a video. Jared fell asleep with his hands up. Like his hip was back and his hands was up like this. I don't know why I didn't take it. Well, the best things aren't able to be captured on video or even through a picture. So, okay, that's probably why. But it was so beautiful. It was. I feel good. I'm extremely, extremely tired. When you're up and you're doing things for the Lord, He can make it that you're not tired and make you feel like you obtained 8 hours of sleep. But when He says, okay, that's enough, now go rest, and you disobey, your body's going to pay for it. And that's what's going on. I should have went to bed at 12:30 instead of like almost 3, just up washing stuff. So I just could not get myself together to get out of the house. It seemed like this thing is like just kind of completely in the way. Okay, I kind of fixed it. Anywho, yesterday was just very, very encouraging for my soul. I feel like Jared also has obtained his second win naturally and spiritually. And it makes me feel amazing as a mom. It's just all about choices, all about growing and being able to hear the voice of the Lord and just being obedient. Literally, it's about just being obedient. Yes, Lord, even before He says anything, my answer is yes. And that's just where I want to be, how I want to be. And I feel so good. I feel so free. I feel so light. I feel so open. I wish I wasn't so physically tired and physically drained so I could really, I guess, be animated in regards to how good I feel, how grateful that I feel. I was talking to my one girl pal about relationships, and she goes on dating sites a lot, and she a lot of things haven't panned out. And had another girlfriend, she goes on a lot of dating sites too, and one panned out for a little bit and then it didn't anymore. And a few of my friends from church was telling me, you know, different people that are married, they went on this one site. Come on, let's get this light. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. They went on this one site. And I was like, all of those people went on that site and they got married? Now, although it was like, oh, wow, like, well, maybe I'll try it. Okay, maybe. The other part of me was like, everything doesn't work for everybody, though, you know. And they're like, well, just go ahead. And if nothing comes out of it in 30 days, you know, we'll just give you your money back. Literally, by the first few days, I was like, blah, just so was not into it, wasn't interested. And I said, I'm going to keep up my part of the deal. But at the same token, it feels like work going on there. Like, I feel like, well, not I feel like, I know, it's like, you're not supposed to be on here. So, I'm going to deactivate my account, matter of fact, when I get home, so I don't forget, because I'm not really on there, so they don't charge my card. But I'm okay in the state that I'm in. Of course, everyone wants to be married and have that, again, healthy marriage, healthy relationship. But listen, you have to be okay with in the state that you're in, and I am. Not saying that I wasn't before, but yes, I do desire to be married and be in a healthy, again, healthy relationship. I want all of my relationships to be healthy, but I don't want to speed up the process. I do not want the thought of dating and being with someone to be at the top of my to-do list, mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally. I don't want to do that. And different times I think that the thoughts whiz through, but sometimes when I talk to other girl pals who are experiencing the same thing, I really feel like that, and I don't mean this as a shade thing, but I believe in transference of spirits. You know, because I've been okay with, like, okay, yeah, I wish I was married. You know, I'm not dating yet, but okay, whatever. And I have moments throughout the year that I can count on, like, one hand that I'm okay. But it's also because I've been very preoccupied with my schedule and other things I've been doing. But even if I wasn't, my mom took up most of my time. And unfortunately, I no longer have my bestie here with me, but Jira is the schedule of like 10 men by himself, him being so busy with ministry. But it's still okay. I feel like I'm still recouping physically, emotionally, spiritually from being a caretaker, not just for my mom, over the last, you know, few years. So I feel kind of good to just, I'm still liking that Selah moment. So to just date for the sake of dating, I've never felt like that. Oh, I forgot my point was when I stated I believe in transference of spirits. I really believe that every time I would talk to specifically like two of my girl pals, that the spirit that they have on them in regards to I want to date, I want to be with somebody, I feel like that it would always like get on me, because normally it's like, oh sure, I want to date, versus like, oh my gosh, it's been forever and I'm actually okay, you know, I'm actually okay. So I'm happy about that. I forgot my whole point even behind that. I did. But long story short, I'm okay. Is that the Lord behind me? Look at that. Look at that sunlight just beaming in. Is that you, Jehovah? Hallelujah. So, happy Monday. God bless you. Continue to keep your eyes on the prize. And the prize is the voice of the Lord. That's the prize in everything, in all things. Yeah. Any battle you're facing, let God fight your battles. Because if you try to do it, you will always, always lose. If you allow the Lord to do it, you'll always come up on top. Because even if you feel like you have one, but it's temporarily and it's a surface one, it won't last. And you'll have to repeat a few things that if you allow the Lord to do it, done deal. Ooh, Jesus. Okay, too much going on up here. Okay. All right, you guys. God bless you. Talk to you later. Bye.